time for the match game. Hollywood Squares, our with Arsenio Hall. Bart Braverman. And from Too Close for Comfort, Ted.
No whistling. I mean, we love your enthusiasm, but whistling is so painful when you all do it together. It's awful.
Oh, shut up.
Or unless it's a melody.
That's right. Sweet Sue or something like that is okay.
Just means you're enthusiastic.
Right. Hi, Jenna.
I just wanted to say hello to my daughter.
Your daughter,
she's
right.
Here in the audience. Hello,
she's
Jenna.
A very beautiful daughter who's five and a half?
Yes, five and a half years old.
Hi, Jenna.
There she is. And another beautiful daughter here. Well, you're going to be glad you came today because the Funny Farm is here. They've been released for the day, and we're going to have a lot of laughs. Now, let's begin by greeting our two players here, Chip Lieberman and Margie Randolph. Yeah! How do you do?
Hello.
Now we're going to get acquainted with these two creatures here.
Creature.
Chip, tell us about you.
I'm from Rochester, New York, where I work at an advertising agency. Oh, somebody pushed me. I'm out here for 4 weeks on an extended vacation escaping the snow. When I left Rochester, it was 4 below with a wind chill factor of 30 below. So I'm enjoying the sunshine.
Well, we're glad to have you out here.
Thank you.
Is Chip a nickname?
Yes. I don't want to know my real name.
We don't want to.
Oh, well, it's not.
You don't have to. I don't want to embarrass you in any way. If you don't want to say your real name, it's all right. Is Margie Randolph your real name?
That's my real name.
All right. Okay, well, Margie, where are you from and all that?
Well, I'm a flight attendant, and I'm based out of Miami, Florida. But I live here... Oh, Miami, yeah. Okay.
Got them from all over.
But I live here in Los Angeles, so I commute to work about 3,000 miles.
That's a long commute.
Yeah.
Jim, you did that for a while.
Did you really? From where?
Yes. I lived in Massachusetts and worked here.
Oh, good. I don't do that.
I live here now. All right. Now, this is the match game. 3 rounds. The winner will go on to meet the returning challenging champion. Challenge a champion on how, well, whatever is going to happen will happen. I don't
know. We'll tell you
later. Yeah. Listen, Chip, you won the toss, so you have to go first.
B, please.
B. Mm-hmm. All right. Pay attention, because ultimately one of you could win $30,000. Here it is. Herb said, I think my blind date works in a deli because... Instead of lipstick, she has blank smeared on her lips. Got one? All right.
Did you mention that Richard Dawson was in the audience? Stand up, Richard. Never mind.
Six guys stood up with bruised lips.
All right, Chip, Herb said, I think my blind date works in a deli because instead of lipstick, she has blank smeared on her lips.
Ketchup?
Ketchup, anything you'd find in a deli. All right. Bart, what did you say?
I didn't say ketchup. Unfortunately, I said mayo.
Mayo. Anything in a deli. You're on the right track. Somebody may say ketchup. You never know, Chip. What do you say, Jim?
I'm very sorry. I didn't say ketchup. I said cream cheese.
Cream cheese is good. Why would you boo a good answer?
I hate these people. Who are they?
I don't know. Cream cheese is not bad. What do you say?
We want names. Oh, I got mustard.
That's your basic spit take.
That's your barf answer, I guess, isn't it? Okay, instead of lipstick,
person.
She has blank smeared on her lips.
Adam and Eve on a raft!
Chopped
liver.
Oh,
play!
You don't appreciate ethnic cooking.
Do people in delis use ketchup and mayonnaise? I thought
ketchup, mustard, mayonnaise, all of those things.
Elyse,
all good.
What?
Never was it more appropriate to have liver lips.
Liver lips. Okay.
Those
all right, you got the hang of it now, right, Chip? Next round you'll score.
Okay.
Let's see what we got for Marge over here.
Okay, Marge.
Marge. Sally said, my husband is always hurting his back at work, and that's because he's a door-to-door blank salesman. Always hurting his back at work.
Can we hurry up? There's an episode of Chips on that me and Jim want to go see.
Daddy helping you at all?
No.
Hey, Punch!
Oh, all right.
Let's go get him!
Okay.
That's it.
Don't look at me.
That was rude. That's what comedy's all about. That's
okay, good. Elyse.
Put it in there.
Put it in there. Let's play. All right, Margie. Sally said my husband is always hurting his back at work, and that's because he's a door-to-door blank salesman.
Weight salesman. You know, like weights?
Yeah.
Come on!
Now, you're trying to think of something heavy, so you thought of weights, yeah.
Right.
Well, you know, anything heavy, like a...
Yeah, that's all right.
Piano or a washing machine or whatever. What do you say?
In the name of love...
hands, you know, 2 miles with heavy hands is all right.
No comment. But I'm happy for her.
Wait.
And happy for you. Wait. Very
no
good.
Comment? What do you mean, no comment?
Well,
did I get the right answer?
You got the right answer.
What's the problem?
Well, the problem is a door-to-door. Do they sell weights door-to-door?
No. Cop a walk.
Okay. I'm going.
To these
hello, Jim.
Let's get physical.
All right.
Two dingalings.
I said door-to-door wrestler.
I want you guys Friday night. You guys Friday night at the Akron Armory. I'll take you all on Friday night. I'll put you in my wheelchair.
Cut. John's on.
Yeah, ooh. I said this because I figured this would get me a chorus of boos. Anvil.
Okay, Elyse.
I said this because I'm from California.
Backpack.
They like her because she's a girl.
You are an extremely illogical group.
Yes.
You boo a good answer, and you cheer a rotten answer.
But she's a lady.
No.
One of the better answers.
Backpack was the right answer.
No, wait a minute. The guy hurt his back. Going door to door carrying something heavy.
They don't care about the
backpack. Is not heavy.
The lady, they don't care about
the
game.
He's demonstrating.
You got it.
Yeah, these guys have been locked inside a mayonnaise jar for the last 6 years. And they...
I'm beginning to believe that.
You weren't so stupid. On to Ted.
That's two, Jim.
Yeah.
All right, Ted.
Well, obviously, the man had to test the equipment he was carrying, so I wrote mattress.
Oh. Well, that would be... So, at the end of round one, it's 2-0 Margie's favor. Round two right after this. Round two coming up. Bing. Now, Margie, you're ahead. You have to go first.
Oh, I go first. Okay, yep. I'll pick A.
A is what she wants, and that's what she gets.
Blue sky.
Bart and Jim, you lay out because you matched her in the previous round. The rest
absolutely.
Of you, please respond to this.
Okay.
Fred Fat is so fat.
Fred Fat?
How fat is he?
He's so fat, he has to jack himself up just to change his blank. Yet about that?
Gene?
Yes, sir.
Yesterday when I jumped off the set, our sound man was over at the Letterman show or something, and he wasn't here. So I'm gonna jump again! Let's go!
Wait a minute!
I was gonna jump. I'm not.
Did you throw him the life jacket? Get the rowboat out. Get him back up here.
Did he get it that time?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Oh yeah. We don't miss two in a row. Did the audience hear that? Did you hear the splash of the water? All right, here we go, Margie. Fred Fat is so fat, he has to jack himself up just to change his blank. He's fat, big.
Okay, pants.
Pants, all right. Arsenio.
I had shoes.
Shoes, good.
What a crowd. This is a great crowd. This is a great crowd.
Once they're hot and once they're cold for you. All right. John, what have you got?
Two shoes.
Two score. Aren't you looking for a pair of pants, Elyse?
Sorry.
Three shoes.
Underwear.
Underwear. Now, Chip, yours.
So my people out there.
You're encouraging them, are you?
No,
you are incorrigible.
Just coming to life after the fourth show.
Don't cry for me, Argentina.
Play.
It's a fun crowd.
You go to the parking lot, all your tires will be slashed. Would you like to see my razor? I keep it right here in my pocket there. Ugly Eunice is so ugly.
How ugly is she?
When a peeping Tom peeped into her window, he blanked. Everyone plays. Everybody. Got it? Okay. Okay, I guess.
And how about that crowd, huh?
Yeah. In the slot.
Yes.
Here we
go. In the slot for heaven's sake.
Ugly Eunice is so ugly, when a peeping Tom peeped into her window, he blanked.
I'll say fainted.
Fainted is good. Not bad. Okay. What do you say, Bart?
You know, Gene, before I give you my answer, I just wanted to say that I suppose in the very near future, at a time I don't want to mention, I'll probably find you at the McCadden Theater, where I'll be performing Uncle Daddy right here in Los Angeles.
Yeah, I really would like to see that.
Well, it's going
to
be good. It's a potential television pilot, and on the other
Plug.
Hand, it's...
What did you unplug? What doesn't work now?
Probably my mic.
Right.
The life story of Kurt Kasner. That's what.
Show and tell.
We'll just drop the.
Why not?
It's. I said he would close the curtains.
Close the curtains. When a peeping Tom peeped into the window, he closed the curtains. Okay.
Come
on.
I said something very logical. I said screamed.
He screamed. Good.
I had a throw up.
He threw up. I find it very strange that a crowd gets turned on by barfing.
Yeah!
Don't you, John?
Barf! Yeah! All right!
Let's see how much of it they have in them, Gene. Barfade!
Chip is looking for fainted. Will somebody real cooperate with her and give her a fainting answer here?
I put myself in his position, and that's what I would have done.
He gave himself up? Okay, Elyse. Good.
She's
got a laugh out of Dad.
Well, Bart and I have the same answer, but I wrote it differently, so they'll like this.
Close the curtain.
Oh, how quickly they turn.
All right, show them.
Stroke.
So there we are at the end of round two. 2-0. Margie is still ahead. Round three. Final round right after this. Third and final round. Bing. Margie, you're still ahead. You still have to go first.
Okay, I'll stick with A.
You want A? All right. Same four people who tried it last time. Arsenio in the lower tier.
Isn't that all?
Mark said, I never should have tried to get fresh with Lonnie. Her living bra blanked me. I find that quite amusing.
Her living bra?
Yes. Okay, Elyse? Margie, Mark said I never should have tried to get fresh with Lonnie. Her living bra blanked me.
Bit me?
Bit me. Well, now we know what turns them on, don't we?
Anything.
All right.
Bite this.
Aha! Three for Margie. Let's see if John makes it four.
I think characteristically, your living bra would slap you.
All right.
Oh, what do you know? What do you know? Oh, thank you.
All right,
I
Elyse.
Think this is the same.
What is that? Snapped at me. How about that?
Yeah!
Ted?
I want another boo. Slapped.
No, slapped is good.
Yeah, nothing wrong with slapped.
Bit and slapped are both good.
This is a tough
You're having a good time in spite of them, right, Ted?
I thought you were friendly.
Okay, Margie, you have four. Chip, that means you need four to tie and five to win. Here we go.
Gene Wood.
Peter the Plumber said.
Who?
Peter the Plumber.
Peter, oh yes.
Peter the Plumber said. He said, when my nose is stuffed up, I don't go to a doctor. I clear it up myself with blank. Got it? I cleared it up myself with blank.
While we're young.
All right. Chip. Peter the Plumber said, when my nose is stuffed up, I don't go to a doctor. I clear it up myself with blank.
Drano.
Drano.
Yes!
Okay. Sounds good to me. Now, there are a couple of good choices here. You know, Drano, Saniflush, Plumber's
You know what
helper.
They say about second choice? Drano, what? Second choice.
Ah.
Second choice. Second choice. First choice. Plunger.
A plunger's good.
Oh, disgusting, good. But first choice.
Wait a minute. Plunger, Roto-Rooter, all of that stuff is good here. A snake, what do you say, Jim? Drano.
He's used it on
I
his
see.
Brain.
It's your first right answer, and I see you are overcome with joy.
I am too happy at this moment.
You're going to shed a tear any moment. But I'll have to move along because we're a little behind here.
I have Liquid Plumber.
Liquid Plumber. It's 4-2 right now. Who do we got here? John.
4-3.
4-3.
Drano.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Elyse.
Drano.
4-4. Ted, it's all up to you.
I could break this tie, couldn't I?
You could break the tie. Or straight. Margie, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Oh, it's great meeting you, too. Thank you.
I'm going to send some gifts to Margie Randolph. Hey there! Congratulations! Now it's time to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring in the three stars. Here comes the rest of the set. Jim, make sure it doesn't squish your foot there. Careful. Hold it. Ah, thank you very much. Now we're all in place. John and I are going to switch spots here. And we've got lots more excitement coming along here. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Hitachi's 13-inch diagonal table model color TV, 100% solid-state, low-power consumption, special signal tracker system, memory fine-tuning, 70-position UHF tuner furnished by Hitachi. It's time for more of the Mets game. Hollywood Squares, our win from Too Close for Comfort, Nancy Dussault. Lydia Cornell.
Valkenburgh, the star of the Hollywood Squares. John Bowman.
Go ahead, really. You get to it. All right, we'll be back with Hollywood Squares. We'll decide who's hosting in the meantime. No, really, you can have it.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Squares.
To the second half, and I have Chip Lieberman. What's your real name, Chip?
Martha.
Uh-huh. Well, now we understand where Chip came from. We also have three brand new and lovely celebrities from Too Close for Comfort. Deborah Van Valkenburgh, Mama Nancy Dussault, and her other daughter, Lydia Cornell. And Deborah, you say you're going to start another show pretty soon?
Teddy's Angels.
Teddy's
Angels. That's a spinoff.
Okay, you're probably ready for another show called Hollywood Squares. Here we go. Let's play. Before we begin, we will reacquaint ourselves with Joyce Reeves. She had a nice, productive day yesterday. She and I said Remington Steel at pretty much the same time, and she's returning with $21,525. And a lot of new friends.
Yes.
Just protect me from these people, and everything will be okay, Joyce. And you are a senior personnel representative.
Very good, yes.
Yesterday, you threatened to tell us what that is.
How long is this show?
Shorter and shorter all the time.
I'm an employment interviewer. That's close enough.
Okay, well, some of these people may be looking for work after we play Hollywood Squares. We're going to play that game until the end of the time's up. Bell, whoever is ahead is the winner. Goes on to play Supermatch up to $30,000. You won 20 yesterday. First game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Joyce Reeves, you start.
Jim, please.
Jim Bullock.
Yeah.
Come on. Women in the U.S. Army are allowed to wear simple earrings with their regular uniform. Mm. But can a male soldier also wear earrings with his uniform?
No.
Or is this attire against regulations?
Why did I get this question?
We didn't know you'd be wearing that outfit.
Jimmy.
You're the only one with pierced ears. That's why you got
Your ratings go down now, okay? Okay.
Are you in the show, certainly?
How about in about a half an hour?
Okay, repeat the last half of the question.
Can a male soldier wear earrings with his uniform, or is this against regulations?
I really don't see how it could be against regulations. Shut up, I'm going to kill you. I mean it.
So it's okay. Okay, quick, before your ears fill in.
It's okay.
Okay, Joyce, he says that it's perfectly fine.
I disagree.
It is against regulations.
Yay.
You are right to disagree. You get the square. Good play. $25 and an X goes up in there. Well, Jim never.
Well,
Chip Lieberman, your move.
Ted, please.
Okay, Mr. Knight.
Yes. Thank you. I love you.
Ted, you have been invited to dinner at the White House.
Often.
Now, according to the Book of Modern Table Manners, is it all right to take your menu and place card as souvenirs, or is that exceptionally gauche?
Well, I must tell you, the last time I was there, I not only took mine, but the people on either side of me, and no one complained, so it was perfectly fine.
He says it's fine.
I agree.
It is. It's all right. Yes, the taxpayers will just pay for more, right? You get the square. Well done. There's an X and an O up there. You've both been right. Joyce, it's your move.
Gene, please.
Mr. Rayburn.
Yes, sir.
You're watching the Glenn Miller story.
Ah, yes.
Once again, Glenn dies in a plane crash.
Mm. Right. Mm.
You begin to cry, Gene.
Yep. It's a sad event. He was a great man.
Does liquid only come out of your eyes, or can it also come out of your
nose?
Don't
say it. Well, as a thespian,
oh, bro.
Pardon me?
Having performed in certain stage productions in which the character was required to weep. I know for a fact, having wept, that liquid does indeed come out of your nostrils in addition to your eyes.
What do you say, Jason? He says it can also come out of your nose.
I agree.
It can also come out of your nose. You're right to listen to that thespian, and you get the square. We get to come back and finish a $100 game with any luck after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Okay, we're going to try to complete this $100 game. It's 50 to 25. Chip Lieberman, it is your move. You are playing O.
Lydia to block.
Right. If you miss this one, Joyce takes the first game.
Pressure.
Lydia Cornell, you are a Siamese twin. Can you stay awake while your twin is asleep? Or do you both wake and sleep at exactly the same time?
First I thought it was going to be a kinky question.
Sorry to disappoint you.
Siamese twins do everything
at the same time.
At the same time.
Is that what you're trying to say? Okay.
This is so confusing.
Quiet, Lydia. Lydia Hall, go off and tattoo yourself. Chip Lieberman. Lydia says that the Siamese twins would both wake and sleep at exactly the same time. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You can stay awake while your Siamese twin sleeps. That is very good playing. You get the square and you do block. Somewhere in here there is a game. And she has just blocked you. You are playing X.
Arsenio to block, please.
Okay, Lydia, yes.
Caught with your hand in the
We've caught you with your side down, Lydia. Arsenio, what makes the average man's heart beat faster? Sex or a really cold shower?
I think, what's that word you always use?
Well, if you have a cold shower, you don't need the former.
You don't need the farmer, did you say?
Gene, I think you've got a phone call. Bye-bye now.
Arsenio Blank.
You know, Gene, with hosts like us, I don't think we need these guests. No. Go ahead, Arsenio. Give me
you
an answer.
Both very clever.
Give me an answer. Sex or a really cold shower?
I'm going to go with the really cold shower. The really is the key word.
He says that makes your heart beat faster. Joyce, agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Sex makes your heart beat faster. Good girl. You're right to disagree. You get the square. Okay. Let's move it along a little bit because we have yet to complete this game. Chip, you are playing O.
Bart to block.
You missed this one. The game belongs to the champ.
Sure, John.
Bart Braverman, who is older? Bo Derek or the curb feeler?
Can I ask what a curb feeler is?
I had the same question. I think it's perfectly logical. It's something that attaches to a car and to the side, and it tells you where the curb is so you don't smash your car in the curb.
Oh, curb feeler.
Oh. Yeah.
Didn't you think
a curb feeler
with a D?
Curb.
Bo Derek or the curb feeler? Definitely the curb feeler is older.
Okay.
Everything's older than Bo Derek.
Bart curbed his feeler and gave us an answer. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
The curb feeler is older than Bo Derek. You are right. Well done. 1946 for the feeler. Okay, you're playing X. Make your move.
Nancy, please.
Nancy Dussault. You're an average person with average hands and average feet. Which grows faster, your fingernails or your toenails?
My fingernails or my toenails? My fingernails grow faster.
Agree or disagree, Joyce?
I disagree.
Her fingernails do grow faster. No, that could be a break in the game. Your opponent gets that square. Your fingernails grow twice as fast as your toenails. Okay, Chip, you're probably more concerned about X's and O's.
Deborah to win?
I'm playing up here.
He's very busy trying to keep track.
Deborah Van Valkenburgh, you are an authentic Barbie doll. Can I bend you over or will you snap?
What do you mean, bend? What do you mean, bend over?
Well, first, like, I have to see a Malibu Barbie.
Essentially, can you bend a Barbie doll or will it snap?
Yes.
Okay, oh. Chip.
Wait a minute. No, I don't know what you mean.
Does the doll bend?
Is a Barbie doll original. Bendable at any
like
point?
Like this or like
well, yes, it's forward,
yes,
right?
Yes, 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 yes. Sit down, yes.
Yes. You can bend a Barbie doll. It won't snap, correct? Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You can bend a Barbie doll over. No, you shouldn't have agreed. Your opponent gets that square and stays in this $100 game. Okay, we're going to be back to attempt another conclusion after these messages. We're having fun. Stay with us. Okay. The game hangs in the balance. It is going to be your move, Joyce. Everything is full up there. There are four X's and four O's on the board. That means if you win this, if you get this question right, you win this game. If you don't, you lose it. Pick a star as a formality.
Elyse, please.
Yes, we need you to say that. Elyse Knight, your dog has a bad case of hiccups. Should you scare him or give him milk of magnesia?
Well, I don't think it's good to scare him. So.
Thank you, Wayland and Madam.
Give him milk of magnesia.
Okay. Agree or disagree, Joyce, for the game?
I agree.
You should give him milk of magnesia. Yay! Yes, you're right to agree. You did it. You get the square, you win the game. Very well done. That rule is there are five X's up there. Five of any symbol wins the game. You have forged into the lead, my dear. But we're going to clear the board, zip right on to the next game, and this one is going to be worth $200. So the game still hangs in the balance the entire day. Chip Lieberman, your move.
Jim, please.
Okay. Mr. Bullock, I'm sorry, you're on. You have always dreamed of having a longer tongue.
Why not?
Can you get a silicone implant to make it longer? Or is this something surgeons don't do?
I really don't understand why I'm getting this question.
It's a tongue! Stop it!
Can this be done by silicone implants or what?
No, it's either can be done by silicone implant or it can't be done at all.
Or cannot be done at all.
Right, those are your choices.
I really have never heard of anyone having a tongue job, so I would say...
So you would say, let's keep it that way. Okay.
Oh.
Okay, I think that he's trying to say that surgeons won't do that. Surgeons won't give you a longer tongue. Agree or disagree, Chip?
Disagree?
It is something that surgeons will not do. You should have agreed with Jim. Who knew what he was talking about? For a change, your opponent gets that square.
I don't see people going, like my tongue job.
Okay, Joyce, pick a star.
Ted, please.
Okay, Ted Knight.
Yes.
You just threw your cat out the window. Will your cat always land on her feet, or do cats sometimes land on their heads?
From how high?
Is the cat
vicious
sober?
Man.
Okay, a general question. I would say, having thrown, never thrown a cat out, but I have seen people do that. I would say, with confidence, unsurely, he would land on his feet.
Okay. He says, cats always land on their feet. Agree or disagree, Joyce?
I disagree.
Cats sometimes land on their heads. Yeah. Very good. Good for you. Meowch! You get the square and there are two X's up there. Okay, Ms. Lieberman, you're playing O.
Deborah the block?
You missed this one. It's a pretty big lead for Joyce. Deborah Van Valkenburgh, you've just gotten engaged. You also just found out that the half-carat diamond your fiancé gave you is a fake.
Get it? This man's laughing at everything.
According to Ann Landers, should you speak with this guy immediately, or should you keep quiet since it's the thought that counts?
That's pretty sleazy thought.
Wait a minute. Sleazy thought. I'd bring it up.
She says, speak with him immediately. Agree or disagree, Chip, to block.
I agree.
You should speak with him immediately. The thought that counts. Sure, it's the thought that counts. Cool. Okay, Joyce, she courted you there. You're playing X.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Here we go.
After the average porcupine makes love with his mate, will he leave her for another porcupine? Or will he be faithful and stick around?
Oh, boy, it's time for another game of Monopoly.
It was painful for me.
First, he's gonna walk funny.
What's happening?
I can't imagine this. I cannot visualize this.
Do anything. Sit down.
Let me see. Two porcupines.
Give me an answer, because we're getting close to the end here.
Now, the choices are, will he leave her or will he stick around?
Stick around, right.
I'd say he's gonna be faithful and stick around.
Okay. What do you say, Joyce?
I disagree.
He will leave her for another. You are a very good player. You have agreed and disagreed right at the right times. So you get the square. That is excellent playing. Okay.
Lydia to block.
He missed this one. Joyce takes the game. Lydia Cornell, in Turkey, it is a custom for a house guest to be met at the front door and given something to put on. Is it cologne or a guest fez? Ha!
In Turkey, it's a guest fez.
I agree.
Agree or disagree to block? You agree? It is cologne. You should have disagreed with Lydia. No, unfortunately, your opponent gets that square and wins another game. Unfortunately for you, anyway. Okay, I guess you have to bring your own guest fez. Joyce, you've got a pretty big lead and time is up. $525. Congratulations once again, Joyce Reed. You did it. You did it through very, very tough decisions.
Yeah.
You played really extremely well. I'm very impressed. Go over there, join Gene Rayburn once again for your shot at the big money. You know where to go. Okay. We have to say goodbye, Chip Lieberman. Yeah, she made some critical decisions today at certain points where she disagreed or contradicted the celebrity, and it worked out for her. You're an excellent challenger. She's leaving here with a total of, the printout says $25. Anybody got it? Hold on. $125. Congratulations, Chip Lieberman. Okay, Gene Rayburn, it's to you.
Okay, John, here we are once again with the champ. We'll return with her and the nine stars for a go at the big money right after this.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Gene Ward, here we go. All right. Another shot at the big money for this person here, who we wish her the very best of luck here. She's got $22,050 at this moment, right?
Right.
Okay. Another $30,000 could be hers if she gets skillful and lucky. It's a combination of both things. Here we go with the super match. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, please write down your best answer to this. Linda Blank. If you choose the answer that they gave us most often, it's $1,000 for you. If you choose their second most popular answer, $500. If it's choosing the most third most popular, it's $250. All right. Three stars, one at a time, if you would, please.
Lydia.
Linda Evans.
Lydia says Linda Evans, big television and motion picture star. All right.
Bart.
What do you Lovelace, say, Bart? Linda Lovelace.
Linda Lovelace. All right, you have two now.
Boo now, I saw six of you in the movie.
Jim.
Ronstadt.
Linda Ronstadt.
Ronstadt.
All right, so you have Linda Ronstadt, Linda Evans, and Linda Lovelace. You may choose one of those or give us one of
your Evans, friends. Evans! Go with Evans!
Linda Evans.
The voice
Linda
of
Evans. Where did that come from?
No,
all right, Linda Evans is your choice. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll first reveal the $250 response. That says Linda Lovelace. That was Bart's answer. All right?
That's all right. Y'all don't have to like him because he was right.
Boo!
Now, the $500 response says Linda Ronstadt. Well, you got two of the three answers the stars gave you.
You did it, you did it.
I would assume that Linda Evans would be up there. Let's reveal the big one, if you please.
Yeah.
It is up there!
Yeah.
All right. Now you've got the $1,000. Right. There's your $1,000. You're going to choose a star now and play the head-to-head match. And after you've made your decision, that star will reveal the hidden number. Remember, it'll be a 10, a 20, or a 30. And we hope it's a 30 for your sake, because we're going to multiply that 30 by your $1,000. Time now to choose a star.
Lydia.
Lydia, yay!
All right, Lydia, grab the tab and give it a yank. We haven't had a 30 in ages. We've got a 10. You are playing for $10,000. There's the big $10,000. Good luck to you. All right, Lydia, this is it. For $10,000, baseball blank. Want to take a look at it, Joyce? Baseball blank. All right, Lydia's finished. Awesome. You collect the money if you match her, Joyce. Here it is. Baseball blank. What do you say?
Bat.
Baseball bat. That's one of the implements, the most important implement, perhaps, other than the ball in the game. Lydia, what do you say?
I'm sorry, Joyce. Baseball bat.
Bat! $3,050 for this woman. We'll be back with Joyce, our champ and the stars right after this. All right, let's find out now which of the stars had the big number.
Take
we'll all grab the cat tab and give it a yank. One, two, three, go. Bart Braverman had it. The big 3-0 over there.
She's crying a little bit less today, but still crying.
She's getting used to winning money. Over $33,000. We're so happy for you. We'll see you tomorrow. Gene Raven inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bauman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive a self-cleaning electric range with a digital timing center and the exclusive no-turn speed broiling system. Broils meat on both sides at once, sealing in natural juices, furnished by White Westinghouse. Because an incorrect answer was inadvertently accepted, the original head-to-head question was discarded and the program edited. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.